Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech. And this past week, there's been a lot of news about the upcoming iPhone 13 or iPhone 12S, if Apple calls it that instead, as well as new iPads, AirPods, Apple Glass, and more. So this is your news update for the week of February 14th, 2021. And the first thing has to do with locked phones or activation locked phones. In fact, Apple made it easier to activation unlock your phone if you're having that issue. So if you go to Apple's new activation lock support website, you can now turn off activation lock. Now, of course, you'll have to have access to your Apple ID and password, or if you forgot the password, you'll have to have access to that email address. Beyond that, if you don't have either of those, you can get started with a support request where if you can verify the purchase of your phone, you should be able to unlock it. So it's a little bit easier than going to an Apple store or calling Apple support. You can do it right through the website. And of course, I'll link that in the description. Now, along with that, if you have a MacBook Pro 2016 or 2017 MacBook Pro that won't charge past 1%, well, if you have one of those that won't charge, like this one actually will charge, but if it won't charge, Apple may offer you a free battery replacement. And so on their website, you can get a battery replacement if you go through these steps to make sure that your device is working properly, but just won't charge. And if that's an issue for you, you can set up an appointment with any of the supported 13 or 15 inch MacBook Pros from 2016 or 2017. It's specific to those devices and only affects some of them. But if you're having that issue, they've offered this program. And again, I'll link that in the description. Now, the first news has to do with Apple's VR and AR headsets. There's new patents that show some of Apple's headsets may have different sort of lenses that will adjust to make viewing more comfortable. So there's a patent that shows this information. And then also they would use advanced eye tracking to allow for maybe controlling the interface just by looking at it. So that would be really interesting, along with gestures and maybe a virtual keyboard so that you could type in the air just using your fingers and it would recognize that with its 12 plus cameras. So it could look something like this. And this is thanks to Antonio De Rosa, who made these concepts and allowed me to use them. But if it looks anything like this, whether or not the name is correct is hard to say. But if it looks anything like this, I think it would be really interesting to use a virtual reality headset like this. So I'm looking forward to that. And then aside from the virtual reality headset, Apple is still working on an augmented reality headset where it would overlay different information over your current reality or your current wherever you are. Maybe while you're walking down the street, you could overlay directions. And Apple is said to be working on micro OLED for this. So not micro LED, but micro OLED that would better project over those displays. So it could look something like this. Again, this is from Antonio De Rosa. And so maybe it'll look something like this in the future, but both of those are still a couple years out either way. So hopefully we'll see something like that, but I'm really looking forward to see what Apple has and what they can do better than say the current ones out there, Oculus Rift, for example. Now, as far as the next iPhones, iPhone 13 or iPhone 12S, well, according to Jon Prosser, despite the poor sales of the iPhone 12 mini, according to recent news saying it's only selling about 5% of all iPhones with the iPhone 12 series, Apple is said to be making an iPhone 13 mini or iPhone 12S mini. So I'll just call it iPhone 13 for now, but it could be called the 12S, but they're said to be making a mini version of that as well. And I think that's the right move for those that still want a small phone. So we should see that next year. We also may see portless iPhones for the high-end Pro models. And it's hard to say if we'll see this, but this comes along the side of what Max Weinbach said, where we'll see stronger magnets on the back with MagSafe. So with that, we could have data transfer through that port instead of having a port on the bottom. Now, we would only see this with the Pro models if this information is true, but hopefully we'll see something like that. I actually am not against a portless iPhone as long as you can transfer data somehow physically connected. So it would be interesting to see that. Now, also according to Jon Prosser, we still may see the under display fingerprint sensor. So while with iOS 14.5, we can use our Apple Watch in tandem with the iPhone to unlock the phone if you're wearing a mask, and under the display fingerprint sensor would be welcome, where you press your finger on it and it unlocks, along with maybe still Face ID. So I would still love to see that. Hopefully we'll see something like that. Also, those who are concerned about their phone getting too warm, well, Apple is said to be working on a vapor chamber to help with cooling, according to Ming-Chi Kuo. And we see that technology in a lot of different phones from Samsung and other manufacturers, where it just helps get some of that heat off of the processor and give you better performance over time. So that wouldn't surprise me if they do something like that. Now, according to Max Weinbach on a leak with Everything Apple Pro, Apple is still said to have a 120Hz ProMotion display in the next iPhone. That's almost a certainty from all of the different leaks we're hearing. So I think that's the right move. Of course, that makes a lot of sense because that's the one thing Apple didn't do this year. Also, iPhone 13 is said to get an always-on display, similar to what we have with, say, Android with the Pixel phone. So if I turn this off, you'll see we have an always-on display with the time and maybe a notifications with the weather. We could see something very similar to this with the battery status below, where it's always on. This doesn't burn in the phone and doesn't use much power on any of the phones that use it, since it's sort of a black and white display that dims it, and then these move around to prevent burn-in to the display. So we could see something like that with iPhone 12s/13. I would really like to see that. I know a lot of people have been wanting that. And that makes a lot of sense if Apple is going to a 120Hz display where they can ramp up the speed and slow it down, similar to what they can do with the Apple Watch, where this isn't always on display. If I move my wrist away, it sort of stays on, dims, and then goes down to about 1Hz or 10Hz to save power. So we could definitely see something like that. There's also said to be an astrophotography mode coming to the iPhone cameras. So with the next iPhone, we could see better night performance and then astrophotography, where you could take a photo of stars better, or maybe the moon, and it could use the neural engine to better process that information. So we could see that along with a video mode that has portrait. So not only portrait for photo, but video, which makes a lot of sense. We've seen this again in Samsung phones, but you could edit the depth of field after you take the video, which would be really interesting. Again, we've seen that, but to have it done really well by Apple is something I would look forward to, where we can have depth of field that looks natural and is controllable after the fact. That would be really nice to see. So all of those are said to be coming to the next iPhone, and I'm looking forward to those. Now, as far as updates are concerned, Apple released watchOS 7.3.1 to the public. Now, this is specific to the Apple Watch Series 5 and SE, and it's to fix an issue where it wouldn't charge. Now, we saw something similar to this last week with a macOS update where certain Macs wouldn't charge. So it looks like there was some weird code that they've fixed, and hopefully it will be resolved. It's not necessarily available to all Apple Watches. Series 5 and SE are specifically mentioned, and there's quite a few people saying they're not seeing it yet for the other devices. However, as far as an iOS update, well, I would expect iOS 14.4.1 or some other similar public release as soon as tomorrow. And the reason I say that is a week or so ago, or almost 2 weeks ago now, Apple stopped signing iOS 14.3, which means there's only one version that you're able to downgrade to or really restore your phone with. Normally, when that happens, within 2 weeks, there's a public release. So it wouldn't surprise me if we see something released as soon as tomorrow, maybe even later today at this point, to fix issues with iOS 14.3, maybe with green tint or some other security updates or fixes that people might be needing. So we could see that. And also I would expect iOS 14.5 beta 2. It's been 2 weeks since last Thursday. It's been a couple weeks since we had a release of beta 1. And since we're on what seemingly seems to be a 2 week cycle, I would expect a beta release. So that seems to be probable as well. Normally we'll have maybe a beta release with a public release the day after, sometimes the same day, but expect some releases this week. Also, Picture-in-Picture seems to be working on YouTube again with iOS 14.5. So if you were using Picture-in-Picture on Safari with YouTube, you should be able to use it. So let's try it out. So here's my video from yesterday. Let's swipe up and Picture-in-Picture is working. This is on the beta. Whether or not this continues to work is completely up to YouTube, but it seems to be working in Safari, which is always nice. So we have the option for Picture-in-Picture now to be working in 14.5 if you use Safari. So hopefully they'll keep that there. Now, as far as a March app event, it looks like it still may be on according to Jon Prosser, and we can expect some new iPads Pro there. So the 12.9 inch like this, maybe an 11 inch, and there's also rumors of an iPad mini as well that I've mentioned before. But expect at least an iPad Pro with an updated processor, maybe even more RAM than we have with this one, and of course with the ProMotion display, which is buttery smooth that I can't wait to see on an iPhone. Also, Jon Prosser is saying to still expect AirPods. So along with that, we could have some new AirPods Pro, maybe AirPods Pro 3. A couple days ago, I posted Apple discounting AirPods Pro significantly on Amazon. They were selling them directly on Amazon for about $70 less than normal retail, and they were brand new. So I linked that on Twitter the other day, and Apple was selling them. So it looks like maybe they're getting rid of some stock for upcoming versions. It's really hard to say, but it looks like we should have some AirPods Pro 2 soon and AirPods 3 soon as well. So expect something along those lines with a March event. Also, Jon Prosser is saying to expect AirTags, and we've heard a lot about that. It was been in the code for a very long time, and AirTags would allow us to put a little tag on an item and then track that if we lost it or just know where it is. And so all of the code is ready to go within iOS, and it seems to be there within Find My. So we're just basically waiting for Apple to release the product. We know it's there. Some people have said we won't see it until maybe the fall event, but Jon Prosser is saying March. So we'll have to wait and see. You just never know with AirTags at this point. It's kind of been in the code forever and ready to go, and we just haven't seen it. So I'm looking forward to it either way, and hopefully we'll see it soon. Now, I'm looking forward to all of those things, and really I'm looking forward to 120 hertz display on my iPhone, as well as iOS 15, which we should see in June. So all of those things I'm looking forward to. Let me know what you're looking most forward to in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.